In this video, find out how to easily make a working Faraday bag or Faraday pouch you can use to protect yourself. Put your vehicle key fobs in to prevent anyone from stealing your vehicle using relay attacks at home or when you are out. Also, put your passport or NFC cards in to prevent access to your data when you are out or traveling. Since this method can be used for any size Ziploc style bag, you can also make one for your smartphones, laptops, and more. It's really up to you. If you try this, then make sure to check out the 4 tests I perform on the bags at the end of the video. You will want to test your bag is working properly too. Frakking Creations, showing you the good stuff on DIY Faraday bags. You may already be familiar with Faraday bags you can buy online, but one thing you might not know is that it can stop working. That's exactly what happened to mine and to many other people, as can be seen if you check the reviews of some of these Faraday bags. Even this pouch we bought for protecting us while traveling has shielding material falling apart inside only after one trip abroad. What shielding material to use? You might be wondering why I'm making a Faraday bag if it will fail anyway. The difference is that we are going to use copper shielding tape. It is thicker and more durable. Plus, if any holes or RF leaks are found, you can easily patch it up with more tape or just make a new one of any size you like. Remember to check our video description for links to the items and apps used in this video so you can make your own. What bag to use? I like to use a Ziploc style plastic bag as the base. The zip feature is quite useful and helps keep the contents in and splash protected from water. Select any size that suits your needs. I've kept many different size bags from packaging used for items I've purchased in the past, and so this is another great way to reuse plastic instead of throwing it out after one use. Before applying the shielding, you can make some adjustments to size the bag according to your needs. Here, I taped the bag smaller, like this, to shorten it. Applying the shielding. Since the copper tape is sharp, make sure to be careful as you apply and smooth the tape. It can cause small cuts on your hands and fingers. To shield the bag properly, start by shielding the edges. Since the edges will wear faster as the bag is used, I am reinforcing it with more layers here. For the bottom layer, it should extend past both sides of the bag. Then, the overhang is folded back to line it up with the bag. Both side layers should line up with the top of the bag, but should extend past the bottom a little. Also, fold these overhangs back to line up with the bottom edge of the bag. Next, shield around the bag using layers parallel with the opening. Each layer should wrap around the bag completely and overlap the other end of the tape. Continue to fold any overhangs over to match the size of the bag. Use as many layers as needed to cover the bag, and make sure to overlap each layer over the previous layer. The top layer should line up with the top edge of the bag and should not have an overhang. Make sure to form the tape onto the bag smoothly while maintaining the proper shape of the bag. Also, make sure to smooth out the tape and make sure it is adhering properly to the bag. Next, make the magnetic shielded opening. This RF shielded opening will help seal the opening from RF signals leaking in or out. To do this, we're going to wrap vertical layers of tape around the opening lip so that, when closed, the two sides of the lip touch and form an RF barrier. The inserted magnets will help ensure both sides are in contact when the lip is closed. We are going to use thin rare earth magnets for this. The magnets are added before taping and are placed a few centimeters apart. Use the magnets to hold each other in place to make it easier to tape them in place. Here, I use one piece of tape to tape vertically from one side of the bag to the other. You will have to measure and size the tape correctly. You could instead use two pieces of tape, one for each side, if it's easier for you. The important thing is to make sure the tape is long enough on both sides to wrap around the lip of the bag, just short of the zipper. This will allow the bag to still zip closed and open properly while maintaining the shielding capabilities. After taping one side, remove the matching magnet on the opposite side temporarily so that you can open the lip and wrap the tape around. Then replace the magnets and finish taping the first vertical layer. Make sure the tape is taped as flat as possible to ensure proper sealing when closed. Continue adding vertical layers with magnets until the whole lip is shielded completely. If you use a bigger bag, note that you will need more magnets. Space the magnets close enough so that the space between is not too big. A few centimeters between magnets should work. Use smaller spacing if you find that you need to. Testing the Faraday bag. Always test your bag before you finish. You will have to test that it blocks the signals you intend to block with your Faraday bag. I will be performing 4 tests on the Faraday bags I made. Find links to the apps used for the testing in the video description below. First test is to test with the keyless entry feature of the vehicle. You can see that when using the key fob placed in the closed bag, we are no longer able to open the car door. Once the bag is open, everything works as expected. Second test is to test with the keyless start or keyless go feature of the vehicle. When the bag is closed, I cannot start the car. The key is not detected. Once I open the bag, the key is detected. The third test is to test with an NFC credit card. The card can be read easily using this card reader app, as can be seen here. Once the card is sealed in the bag, we no longer can read the card. The last test is to test the larger bag for blocking cell, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth signals. Here, I use the Faraday Bag Tester app. Success! We can block all three signals using our Faraday bag. If your testing fails, you may need more shielding layers, or may need to make sure the opening is shielded better with more layers, more magnets, or both. Protective cover. Since copper tape has sharp edges, you will want to do this last step so that you protect your hands and your clothes. You don't want small cuts on your hands or small holes in your clothes pockets when you use your bag, so use some packing tape to wrap around the bag parallel to the opening. As before, make sure to overlap the tape. Alternatively, you can buy some vinyl wrap like this carbon fiber one to give your bag a cool finish. There are many styles of vinyl wraps to choose from, so find one that suits your needs. If you enjoyed our video, please subscribe, like, and share it so it can help others.